I can't abandon my post here. Time is running short for me. It would mean a lot to Queen Imurato and Rebellion.
Hey, Laura, do you have a minute? Come over if you have time. Uchu has something to ask me. Uchu and I were talking, and, well...
Uchu, what's on your mind?
The day of Edsley's coronation is approaching. Soon he will be a man and take the first steps towards becoming Paititi's future king.
Oh, that sounds like a day to look forward to.
It's the hope for that day that keeps a lot of us fighting Amaruo and his cult.
Sometimes we all need to remember what we're fighting for. Is there something I can help you with?
When Edsley's father Sairi died, Unaratu bestowed the honor of surrogate father onto me. One of my duties is to gather three sacred items for the ceremony, but...
But with all that's happening right now, you aren't able to. What are these items?
They are the Savior's amulet, the champion's bow, and the king's horn. Each a blessing from the ancestors of the future king.
Tell me what you need, and I'll see what I can do.
I already have men retrieving the amulet and bow, but if you could find Kabil, the instrument maker, and get the king's horn from him, you would be doing us a great favor. He's been difficult. I sent two men and both have failed. Perhaps you could talk to his wife.
I think I can manage that.
Be mindful. Kabil can be prickly sometimes, but Abra, his wife, has a way of dulling his edges.
What are we doing here? I never wanted this to happen. Now Etsley's been captured.
Etsley's a strong kid.
Yeah. He's a warrior. I know. I still hate this. This Spanish document relates one of the many stories of El Dorado, the Golden One. When the first Spanish exploration ships returned home with their holds full of gold, the news spread like wildfire, and the stories got more extravagant with each retelling. Rumors of the Golden City gave birth to countless expeditions to the New World.
Thank you.
Are all these young people crazy these days? I've seen kids scramble like goats in the heights above the village. Scares me to death. I hope you've grown out of your wild stage, young woman.
Not quite yet, I'm afraid.
Of course you haven't. But you will. So will these children. They will tire of whatever they've found up there. Eventually.
November 29th, 1603. After dinner, Lopez left the city. I followed, worried he might not return. I found him standing by the riverbank, lips moving as though in prayer. Not wishing to disturb him, I waited. His communion with God must have lasted through the night, and I regret to admit I fell asleep, for the next thing I knew, Lopez stood smiling serenely over me, the morning sun behind him creating a halo. He helped me to my feet and clasped me in a strong embrace. Truilos, I know where to find the artifact, he whispered in my ear. Jonah, I think I'm close to the mine entrance.
Uchu says it's at the edge of the mountain. He sent a rebel ahead to open it.
Thanks. Oh, I can't figure out what this means. I don't understand. It's almost like a creel. I don't understand. It's almost like a creel. These ceremonial ceramic jars are used to store corn beer or chicha. The bottom of these apu are usually pointed, to aid when pouring into smaller serving containers. Here it is.
I'm in.
Unuratu just left with Hakan. She'll be ready when you open the gate.
All full up. Can't carry any more.
Yantala suktal detel ukil el kiko. Walkila, shena choaba, malo bin lak.
Right track. Careful.
Eshipalchuko so okwautan
tak belama. Mauka tuya tuskutaki kuba lekushimakobo.
Oksahola le nono. Vale misbalu belal. Yankoksik tuyole kukulkan lebejo.
Minha.
This looks like the right place. Impossible. I can't carry anymore.
There's the gate I need to open. Now, I need to open that gate. The gate mechanism might be on the top of that wall.
Duni Shokol! Kalampil!
Mother! Would you get him out of here?
Jonah.
How's Edsley?
Fine. They got him out, but Unaratu was captured.
Oh no. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm going after the box. I don't know how long it'll take.
Do what you have to.
Thanks. The Eye of the Serpent. That's it. There's a temple down there. I got Unuratu captured. What's Dominguez gonna do with her? As long as he needs the box, he'll keep her alive. I hope. November 26th, 1603. At dinner, Lopez asked me if I believed these heathens were worthy of the artifact's alleged power. I had to admit that the Paititians seemed noble and industrious. However, their taut skin, stretched tight over sinewy muscles, and lack of shame made them more similar to beasts. And what of our leaders in the society? He then asked. Should they be able to wave their perfumed and ring fingers in any direction and expect us to obey, to return and sit at their side when they beckon? Do they not treat us as inferior beings, as beasts as well? I had no answer. What he'd said was heresy and treason, but in some way, I wondered if it wasn't the truth. Who made these things? It's not Maya or Inca. High, but I could dive. This is incredible. They carried a sacred object to a great temple. The Box of Ish. What was that? 21st of December, 1603. We've entered a cenote not far from the city and set up camp in a small alcove. Lopez has spent the evening staring into the flames, utterly ensorcelled, his dinner untouched. Twice I attempted a conversation, but his silence rebuffed me each time. He is utterly focused on this artifact. If I were a more superstitious man, I would wonder if the artifact is speaking to him directly. The soldiers keep to themselves as well. They seem anxious for battle. One of their dogs stared at me all evening, as though I were to be his next meal. Ugh.